of Jack and Jill. And I don't mean the couple who went up the hill. I just mean a couple of lovers that live next door, and they're always battling, and I'm trying to keep the score. They're always petting and poking and jabbing and joking and cooing and cracking and wooing and whacking. They keep necking and knocking, singing and socking and squawking and squeezing and burning and freezing. Why, he holds her hands as long as he's able, but when he lets go, she bops him with a table. They start right in, patting and pinching and clouting and clenching. They're enjoying themselves, having a good time. Now, Reverend Green thought he'd call one day on this nicely newlyweds across the way. But just as the pastor knocked on the door, a straight right connected mop, he hit the floor. They was petting and popping and banging and bopping, cooing and kissing and hitting and missing. They kept on grooving and grieving and loving and leaving, kicking and cackling and tickling and tackling. Now, one night a neighbor tried some intervention, but one short jab knocked out his good intention. They started right in, stewing and stabbing and jiving and jabbing, having a good time. Once a lion escaped from a circus train. He strayed in Jack and Jill's domain. Just then they got in a towering rage. Lion took one look and jumped back in his cage. They started in swatting and swaying and plotting and playing and stomping and stabbing and grooving and grabbing. They kept dancing and ducking, tripping and trucking and plotting and pleading and banging and bleeding. Her mother said, "I'll go right in there and fetch her." But Mom came out riding on a stretcher. They started right in, hitting and holding, fainting and folding. They was enjoying themselves, having a good time. Now once a reporter called on the wife just to gather some data on her hectic life. She told him she'd never find time for books. She's always busy ducking left hooks. They was always swatting and swaying and socking and singing and cutting and cuddling and messing and muddling. They kept on fondling and fussing and kissing and cussing and tapping and teasing, squatting and squeezing. Once a voice called out, "Stop, I'm the law." But all he stopped was a haymaker to the jaw. They started in jiving and jumping and throbbing and thumping. They was enjoying themselves. You see, they were in love. Ain't married life wonderful? Hey, will somebody call Dr. Kildare? Is Dr. Christian in the house? Huh?